Good morning, everyone. We are up, we're ready. We've just spent 10 minutes applying sun cream and everything, so we're nice and protected. What's today's plan, Elle?
We're going to Animal Kingdom!
That is why Ella looks like such an adventuring girl. Look, oh, hold on, she's not in focus. There she is, okay. All right, we're ready, we're gonna go. Oh, we've got quite an exciting day today. We get to go and meet Mickey and Minnie in Tusker House.
Yeah, Megan and Daniel have given us a character dining meal, and we're so excited.
Yeah, so that's a 2:10.
2:10, yeah.
And then we're thinking it's gonna be quite a short day today. We're gonna go to the park this morning for opening, do what we can, go to Tusker House, and then probably come back once we finish in Tusker House. Maybe go back to Dave and Buster's, have a bit of a chill that evening.
Yeah, grab some food.
Yeah, we're going to go for a proper meal on iDrive, so that'll be good.
My boat is a little bit wonky, I'll need it. But
we're ready to go. I just have to pack a bag, a rucksack. All those drinks we bought yesterday, we're going to take them. And then start heading off, aren't we? We had an issue yesterday where we snapped the fan. But we always carry some of this plaster tape when we go travelling. And it comes in very handy. We repaired my Fitbit last time.
Yep, and now it's repairing the fan.
So we just arrived at Animal Kingdom. Just got dropped off by our lift. Following the signs in it already. Looks very nice, doesn't it? Looks like a beautiful day. All the palm trees are up there. We've got the lights and everything just popping off. Even the signs in the car park for whereabouts we were sat instead of having numbers. They had different things.
Thank you.
They had like peacocks and yetis and loads of different things. It's really cool. Here we are at Animal Kingdom. Got a beautiful elephant for the facade here. And also two dinosaurs. That's cool.
And also two dinosaurs.
Oh, they've got a dinosaur land now, haven't they?
Yeah,
here.
They do.
That's probably why.
And originally it was meant to have a mythical beast, that's why that one's like a dragon-y kind of thing.
Okay.
They were meant to have like a mythical beast section.
Well, I guess they've sort of got that with Avatar though, haven't they?
Yeah, I guess it's now it's sort of come beast. Back in.
I wonder if we'll be getting anything else for the new Avatar film. We were discussing this the other day about how we're going to have to see if there's a reborn love for Avatar with this new trailer. We've not watched the new trailer yet, we were supposed to do that last night and I've only just remembered now. So there we go. Triceratops there, mythical beast over there, and an elephant right there. We are in. What I'd like to do, I get two maps, so we can use one of the maps. And the other one, we've got a little theme park shelf at home that we, which way are we going now?
I've no idea, babe. You've got the map.
Hold on. So instead of having a castle, they've got the Tree of Life at Animal Kingdom, which we'll see in detail in a little bit. We were going to go to the safari, but it doesn't look like it's open just at the moment. We get two maps, so we can use one of them, and the other one, try and keep it as crisp as possible so we can cut the map out and frame it.
This sign, it might say when it opens.
And then we've got like a theme park shelf as well that we sort of collect maps for, don't we, which is pretty fun. There you got like Timon and Pumbaa there.
Then we'll be on the next one, I think it just flipped over.
So a lot of these open
so
at 9:30 and 9.
Be on the next. 8:15, so we can go if we want.
Right, we're going to head to Kilimanjaro Safari. We're trying to be one of the first people on.
Because we want to see the animals in the morning. It's meant to be like better.
Yeah, when it's cooler, the animals are a bit more active, which is in the morning and the evening.
If you go on in the middle of the day, it's too hot for them. It's too hot for a lot of the animals, so they're just a bit lazy. Lying around.
We're following science to Africa.
Cool.
Because the safari is at the back of Africa, and then it looks like the safari has another map all to itself that's not on this map because it's so big. Is this heading into Africa? Ella being her little adventurer person. So far, this looks very jungly, very natural. It does look very nice. There's Harambe Harbour down there.
Oh, look, Frank.
Tusker House. Oh, that's easy to find. That's where we're heading for lunch later on. This guy isn't joining us, though.
But yeah,
so this is Tusker House, which is where we have character dining later on. Unfortunately, we couldn't get breakfast. Unless you wanted to ask and see.
No, I'm happy with lunch.
Smells good. Tamu Tamu as well. That's also where what is, sorry, Elle?
This was the Festival of the Lion King, is I think, it's the first time.
Yeah, it's on here. Called Festival of the Lion King as well. So Festival of the Lion King is like a little, stage show, isn't it?
Yeah, it's got acrobats, it's got singing, dancing.
But they use a lot of the same costumes as they do for the actual stage show of the Lion King. Which is pretty cool. So there's Kilimanjaro Safari over there. Looks like it's not quite open just yet, but we should be one of the first couple of people on there.
Yeah, maybe.
So we'll get on there.
That's great too.
Ronnie. There's some pretty little birds.
He didn't have his head.
Yeah, look at
this guy. Oh, this is just in the queue for the safari. We've just bought a lightning ring for Avatar Flight of Passage.
Yes, yeah, so
just to ensure we get on that one.
After our Tusker house. So that'll be like probably the last thing we do for the day.
Yeah, last thing we'll do and then we'll head off. That'll be fun.
Yeah.
So we're just gonna go on the safari now. We'll see if we can get some safari footage. Depends what animals are out and what we can see.
I'm very excited though.
These are our tour buses.
Oh, safari vehicle!
Kilimanjaro Safari.
I saw a baby rhino.
A baby white rhino.
Little fluffy ears, and he was so cute. And his name was Logan, and it's his birthday next week.
This week.
This week, and he's gonna be 1 year old.
1 year old. It was really good that you just go on a safari, a big safari trip. The guide was really good. It was really knowledgeable, telling
me
all about
things. Cool stuff.
We saw as much as you could. They talk about all the conservation they do, like inventing this beehive that scares off elephants.
So yeah, so they don't have to kill the elephants, yeah.
Oh, it was really good. And we also found out that they do a conservation project, so anything you buy at Animal Kingdom, you can round up to the next dollar, and all of that donation is matched by Disney and then goes straight to the conservation
fund. Yeah, which is super cute.
It's super cool. And there's pin stations, so I'm sure we'll be rounding up a few purchases today.
Oh my god.
And down this way.
I can't believe
and there's a tree
I saw
in front of us. Oh wow!
I can't believe I saw a baby. I know.
That's all Ella wanted to do this holiday, and she got to. Well, it's not all she wanted to do. That tree of life is massive.
It's so
it's
amazing.
A giant. It's a giant. It's based off a baobab tree. It's a giant. It's a fiberglass tree. They've made all the bits, but it's all made up of different parts of animals. Every part.
Yeah, I don't think you can see it right now because the sun behind it. But
every
we'll show
of it
you
is
later.
Like snakes and. Tigers and wings for animals and birds.
Oh, it's beautiful.
It's huge as well. So a baobab tree, they grow to that sort of size. Maybe not like quite that big, but there's some huge ones on the safari that we saw.
Entering Asia. Trying to find Expedition Everest. This is just stunning, isn't it? Just a little monkey. You're right, bud.
Did you see that? Hey, you. It's the best part of
the. He's just hanging around.
I like how. All of the like enclosures, this just looks like bamboo scaffolding on like an old building, which adds to the theme, but it's obviously an enrichment for him. It's
yeah.
Great.
He's having a great time in there.
It is.
There it is. Himalayas.
Harley didn't have her shoes on and they
right
really
in Orlando,
good.
Florida.
There we go. There's a train going up.
Oh my lord.
Nah, this park's incredible.
There he is again.
The fact that they've got theming inside the enclosures for the animals is wild. So yeah, we're heading to the Himalayas now. Gonna ride Expedition Everest. Legend of the Yeti, is it called?
Something like that, yeah.
Which is supposed to be a good one. It just looks beautiful. I mean, I'm in love with this park.
Must be 1 Yeti foot tall to ride.
So Yeti foot's 44 inches apparently.
There we are.
This is wild. It looks so cool, isn't it? Got fruit out for the monkey overlords. I already do. I already do. Oh. See, this is why the queues would be absolutely fine. Because you could just...
Walk,
yeah, I'd come and look at this as a museum. Whoa. It's so cool, isn't it? Tiger and bear dung. Wow. Been on it once.
We went straight back round.
We went straight back round because it was so good. Look at that. Oh, but this is really steep. Look at this. What? This is holding the camera flat. Look how steep this is. A Yeti. There's the tip of Everest. I don't know what everyone complains about. It's well easy to get up. There's a train. Here we are at the top of Everest. Just a little bit further to go. So that's Expedition Everest done twice. We did an instant re-ride.
Yeah,
it was
insane. It's so fun.
Because I was saying to Ella, there's not many that I wanted to go on straight away. There's a few that I wanted to go on straight away, but you couldn't because of the ride times. We did it with Lost Coaster.
Yeah.
That was great. We did it with this. I don't know. You don't, for an all ride, it's really good.
It's so fun and really smooth, we were saying.
Yeah.
Like, considering.
Oh, no, that was great. I loved it. What are we doing next then?
I don't know. Let me check my phone, check the app.
Yeah. I've got the map here. I'll show you what the map is. I'm going to put it on this bush and we'll show you and we'll decide what we're doing next and where we are. So. It's like a real expedition. This is the map. We are currently here. This is Everest. We're here. We've just done the safari, which was this bit up here. Pandora's down here. We've got a lightning lane later on.
Dinoland. We just
go to Dinoland here, which is like a... We'll show you when we get there. It's pretty cool. You excited, Elle?
Yeah.
You having a good day?
Yeah.
That's the most important thing. The theming is just on another level. And then we're going to cross this bridge here, which... It's not the prettiest bridge, but then it's going to be a completely different sort of theme in then.
Yeah.
There's a big lake there in the middle. Oh, it's great. I'm having the best time.
Good.
You having a good time?
Yeah.
That's what we want. So we just went and had a little toilet break. Now we're coming to Dinoland and look at this thing. It's huge.
It's humongous.
That's bigger than actual dinosaurs. Dino-rama.
There he is.
Wow. So this place, everyone slates the theme in here because it's like in a car park.
But it's themed to that.
It's themed to that, but people just say it looks like it's a car.
Like it's meant to be like a little fairground carnival.
Yeah, it's just turned up in your town.
Kind of thing, yeah.
Maybe we're on a road now, but it's a footpath. Oh, yeah.
We're heading to Dinosaur.
Here we are. I'm excited. So we just had a picture taken out outside the Cementosaurus. That was fun. And now we're heading to Dinosaur, and I believe we go back in time.
Yeah.
And you gotta get back to the future. Look at this thing. I like dinosaurs, and then it's just dinosaur all over the shop here. It's cool.
Yeah, this is
Dinoland USA. That's where it is.
Yeah, this is Dinosaur. It's like a dark ride. It's based loosely based. It's got the characters from the dinosaur film, which is a very random film to have a ride about.
Never seen it. But, it looks like a big meteor coming to crash down though. Yeah. That's cool.
Here we got dinosaurs.
Oh wow.
And we're going in there. So again. It's like a little museum in here.
Look at
him. Oh, he's cute.
He's a camel bar.
This is so cool.
It is.
Oh my goodness.
Nothing can survive that, right?
So we are going on a tour back in time.
Because the past is the future.
Yeah, the future of museum exhibits is to go back in time, but the other guy, he's being a bit sneaky and he wants to bring back an iguanodon. So that's what we're doing. And we're getting dangerously close to the asteroid that killed all the dinosaurs. What could go wrong?
Let's go get that dino. Computer, what are you tracking?
Styracosaurus.
Not our dino.
Warning, meteor shower in range.
Just little one.
Gloria rabbit. Hadrosaur. Raptor.
Time to get serious. Lock the autopilot on homing signal now. Oh. Hang on! I'm tracking a big albino on the scope.
Look out!
Computer, pull stuff! Identify!
Okay.
Carnotaurus.
Computer, now what?
Carnotaurus.
Oh, no. That's it! Abort mission! Abort! Abort!
Iguanodon.
Forget it! Get them out now!
Asteroid impact.
Brace yourself!
What did you think of that, Frank?
I was going to raise my head.
That was wild. It was really like rickety. It was really fun though.
It was really fun.
I checked my head. It's all checked. Oh, these. These little guys for the museum. I don't know why these ones are. $20. Maybe we'll be coming back.
Triceratops.
Yeah.
My favourite dinosaur.
That was wild. That was really fun, that one.
Ella's got a new friend. This guy's got a cool Mohican.
Look at him.
He's cool. Funny. He's big. He's not just that though. He's got a tail and everything. I don't know why he wouldn't, but shit. Just cool. Now heading into Dinorama. There's a little spinny ride near, isn't there?
Yeah.
Who needs pterodon flyers when you can get on... What's this one called?
Triceratops spin.
It smells good.
There's a pin trader man over there.
Oh, we'll go and check out the pin traders too. We do still need to pick up a lanyard though,
yeah,
for you, don't we?
There's something there. There's one that's Mickey Mouse on there.
Oh, we'll check these lanyards out. We're going to get on this Triceratops spin. Then we'll do some pin trading maybe.
Yeah.
Cool.
Feet and legs inside.
We're on Triceratops spin.
Yay.
We got meteors flying around. Me and Ella. Hey. Ah. Got a little knob here that goes up and down, and then there's one at the back here that tilts it forward and backwards. Ooh. Oh, I really like Dino Land, yeah, see?
Yeah!
That's Dinosaur Souvenirs where we just were. And there's some little carnival games you might play after this.
Yeah.
We'll see. Hello.
Yeah, this one.
You want Toy Story, aren't you?
Can I get this one?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. You're now an official pin trader, aren't you, Earl? And then we've got this little pouch as well that we could put the tickets in, couldn't we?
Go on, baby. Oh, that one was close.
Come on. Oh. Oh. Oh, you did it! You won. Thank you so much. You too. You one of them.
It's really close. And it looks like we have a winner. Great job.
So we just finished doing some Dino Arcade games. I like what we won. We got a Mickey and Minnie.
And we've got the Dino Institute t-shirt.
There we go. Look at that. That's cute. And our official Disney toys as well, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, really cool.
That was fun. We weren't expecting to win anything, but we're coming out with two. That's pretty decent.
That was a lot of fun.
That was fun. Where are we heading now then?
Ooh, let me have a look.
I think we'll be going back towards the entrance.
Yeah.
So we've done Dino Land. Let's have a look at the map, shall we? Do you want an ice cream or anything else?
Sure, we can do. Oh. Another on Adam's treat hunt. We're about to get the Yeti sundae. From this very, very fancy looking ice cream truck. Here's our Yeti sundae. It's got a cute little chocolate Yeti. Are you gonna have a try?
Yeah. So it's vanilla ice cream, chocolate icing, and a blue cake crumb with a little Yeti wafer.
Chocolate.
Almost white chocolate.
Mmm.
Yeah. Soft serve.
Can't go wrong. The blue cake crumb is it's cakey.
Yeah, and then blue sugar, I think, as well.
Also, snowflake.
Oh, a little snowflake.
So, the Yeti sundae. One, the picture is tiny. This thing's massive.
Uh-huh. I thought it was going to be half this big. Yeah.
But this is good. Got chocolate soft serve at the bottom as well.
The little blue sugar's tasty. The blue cake is tasty.
Mm. Chocolate soft serve is just like chocolate ice cream. I'd say... So how it looks, with this cool Yeti on it, I'm going to give it a... That brings it up from just being simple soft serve. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say it's a 7.
Yeah, I'd say a 7. I think that's fair.
Mm.
Delicious.
Very tasty.
We're about to head into Festival of the Lion King, the show. Now we've gone for the 11 o'clock showing because, well, it's 10:45 now and we're at a loose end. So we're going to do that and then we're going to head back up to Birds of Flight,
if we can catch it,
or see where the next one is and see if we can get that one. We just had our Yeti sundae.
Yeah, belly full of ice cream, it's great.
Yeah, had a Yeti sundae and an ice cream sandwich, a Mickey ice cream sandwich, so... I'm very happy for my ice cream today. It's a nice hot day. Not too humid.
No, it's actually really lovely.
But it might be to do with the trees and stuff. There's a lot more shade in Animal Kingdom.
Lots of trees.
It's really cool. We're enjoying it. So we'll see if we can get a little clip of this, shall we? This is the stage for Lion King.
Thank you.
just finished in Festival of the Lion King. It was great.
We
got quite a bit of footage, I think. The songs were good. They used all the good songs from the all the songs from the film. It was only half an hour long.
It was brilliant.
But yeah, it was great. Now we're heading over to Pandora. We're going to see the floating mountains. That's going to be cool. And jump on Navi River Journey, hopefully, right? It just looks so cool.
Like everything.
So now we're just on a road that's got basically a path. A path that's got nothing on the way to Pandora. But it's just, look at this. Take this in.
It's beautiful.
And considering there's floating mountains in Pandora, which, if you've not seen these, wait until you see these. It's crazy.
What?
You can't see a thing. You wouldn't know. You wouldn't know. So even like the street lights now are all alien. They're pumping out crazy sounds. And we are heading over to...
Wow.
Nah, that is huge. So this was on the Imagineering story as well. They showed you how they made it, but it's still, it's just crazy. There's a big mech from the films.
I didn't realize there was this. Just picked up the Night Blossom, which is like a slush from Pongu Pongu.
It's crazy, this place is wild.
What is this? It's like apple and lime with little boba balls, I think.
It's apple and dessert pear limeade.
Nice. With little balls on top.
Right. This one comes with a big boba straw, which is handy. Oh, that's
it's
nice.
Like.
It's quite tart. There's limeade, but the apple comes through. Really sweet, but refreshing. It's cold and refreshing.
That is nice. Yeah,
that's better than the frozen apple pie.
Tartness to it, which is delicious. From the lime.
And the boba balls are, I think they're a lime flavour as well.
Oh yeah, they're delicious.
This is crazy. The whole avatar line is just wild. We're going to be so many people's pictures. We're still right behind them now. Hi. We are about to head into Navi River Journey. We've been queuing for
about an hour.
So it's not too bad. We just have to go through this cave and then we get to see it onto the boat. And hopefully they've got this really cool animatronic going.
Yeah, I really hope so.
If we do, we'll get a video of it because it's incredible.
Through Pandora, so yeah. It was all like crazy animals and
unfortunately we didn't get the big animatronic.
It was very sad, but it's okay.
Yeah, the shame in this song wasn't an animatronic, it was just the screen at the time.
It still looks really good though, doesn't it? Like the screen, they've done a good job with the screen.
Yeah, but it's not as impressive
just
as the animatronic.
But yeah.
We will maybe go back next time we're here.
We'll see.
We're just looking for a toilet at the moment. Have a little toilet break. And then, it's time. We've got an hour, so we might make our way to Are there any shows on at half one?
Yeah, there was the Feather Friends of Flight.
So we're going to go and see the Feather Friends of Flight and then make our way to Tusker House.
Amazing.
This is completely my aesthetic. All of this.
Explorer, yeah. Kind of.
I'm living my dream. Even as a 27-year-old male, here I am.
We're heading to... It's tough to be a bug now.
Nope.
We just passed the system. We're going back in that later. Well, maybe not today. We're heading to...
Feathers. Friends in Flight.
Speaking of which... two pirates just flew over. It's just around this corner. Starts in approximately 15 minutes, so hopefully we'll get a seat.
Yeah.
And then, once that's done, we get to head to Tusker House for dinner.
I'm so excited.
We've looked at the menu. It looks pretty cool. We've got mac and cheese, you've got loads of curries and
salads. And
salad. Yeah, salads in the US are a bit strange. We'll show you what we mean. But yeah, we'll see if we can get any.
Look, it's Kevin!
Oh my gosh. There's a feathered friend.
There is a feathered friend. The biggest feathered friend.
Very big.
Hi, Kevin!
Oh, he's sleeping.
He's seen a cracker. He's dropping cracker on people.
What we'd like to do is give all of you an up close view of these birds. You want a closer look? Yeah, Yoshi, do you want to give them that?
Surprise! The show is in 3D! No glasses required. That's going to happen a lot. Because like Lisa said, that's a really good way to get all of you an up-close and personal look with these birds' adaptations. Like these cool white wingtips, that's one of my favorites, as well as these awesome dinosaur feet and that funky-looking beak that they'll use to eat all sorts of fun stuff.
Yeah,
yeah, come on, Daisy, what do you think?
Very nice.
Catches prey, heads up. So cool, right? So yeah, he's gonna swoop down on his prey, use those talons, and that is how he's gonna catch his prey. What sets them apart is he gives them a treat. So it's kind of like our way of thanking the birds for doing something we want. So if they do something we like, we give them, you can go back. You just untie my shoe.
Weird.
And you're giving him treats for untying my shoe.
No, I'm giving him a treat for coming back to the rock since he left me last day.
Okay? Well, you want to be careful, right? Because these birds pick up on things pretty quick, and if you give them a treat for something, they'll probably do it again.
Look at them! Of all the things that she has learned, I have to say my favorite is she knows a song. Do you want to see if she'll sing?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right. Are you ready? Let's sing.
Take flight and your spirits soar forever.
have a wonderful great. Rest of the day.
We just saw a giant bald eagle. There it is.
Look at that. So big. That's crazy.
It's the little guy playing some music.
Cool. Let's go get some lunch.
That's what we just saw, and it was incredible. All bird shows we've ever seen.
Yeah, we love a bird show.
Yeah, man.
It was awesome.
Aww. Turn around, turn around quick. We went to speak to a guy, had to give him my American number. They're going to send us a text when they have a table ready for us. And then we're going to stick around in this area, so we're really close. We're just going to take some pictures and stuff and take in the scenery.
Well, adorable. You look very cute. Look at this. That is insane.
It's a full Tusker House playset.
Tree of Life.
Tree of Life playset.
Sorry.
Food on your mind.
So they sat us down in Tusker House.
Yeah,
we've got to wait for our server, but we've got this little postcard with everyone's signatures on it. It looks very beautiful, doesn't it? Mickey Mouse. Ella can see Mickey Mouse, he's just there. Oh, she's very excited.
Included, so soft drinks are included. I got an orange juice, I got a Coke. Look at this.
Some bread.
Tiger bread, which is...
I think it's zebra bread.
Oh, sorry, zebra bread.
It's got a little bit of butter if you want any of that.
White bread.
Just Mickey, just casually in the background.
We just met Mickey, we've got a little video. And then, honey.
Wow.
You want to try and see what it's like? That was really nice. I don't know what the white stuff is.
The white stuff?
Butter.
Yeah, I think it is.
It's really good though.
Amazing. We're just getting some food. Yeah, I want all of these things. It smells really good. So first go, we've got a bunch of different curries, some rice, like...
rice?
Yeah, that's it. Some mashed potato, some mac and cheese. I only got one of the salads so far. It's very exciting. And we've got some bread on the side. Insanely good. Like,
it's a little bit more cheaper.
Yeah, but you know what I mean? Like, it's food that you were getting in a theme park.
Yeah.
If I went to Woodcutter's Grill and had a sit-down meal in Horton Towers, this would not be it. It's like delicious, flavorful, spicy.
Well cooked as well.
All feels like homemade, you know what I mean? Like, the mango chutney's like real big chunks of mango, like, it's amazing. I've not had one thing on here that I've not been obsessed with.
I've not stopped shoveling food into my mouth.
Good sign. You
know. And it's all you can eat. It's buffet style. So let's just play one.
All the dishes are African inspired here. And I'm actually blown away. Quite adventurous for like a kid's park as well. There's some really spicy stuff. It's all delicious. All of it is 10 out of 10.
So this is my second plate. I got a little bit of salmon, some black-eyed bean salad, cornbread, potato wedge, and then some like quinoa and chickpea salads. They're very tasty. I've got a coconut curry vinaigrette over the salad, which is very nice. A little bit more bread. Only a small plate, I'm pacing myself, because they do have desserts. And as anyone who watched my previous buffet vlog knows, I like to sample all the desserts. Tusker house. Daisy's just over there. So they come round, character dining is where they come round to all the tables, interact with you a little bit. They can't really talk, so they do all the actions and points and stuff. It's cute. Ella's just going to get some more curry. I'm about to go and get Ella.
Ella's coming back with a plate of curry, I'm guessing.
Oh, she got some mac and cheese. This bunny chow is like curry vegetable curry. It's really nice.
This one's my absolute favourite.
Yeah, that was probably my favourite as well.
Potatoes, courgettes,
and then the creamy mash with onions is great.
I don't know what they put in that. Probably 10 tons of butter, I guess.
And the mac and cheese is also great. Americans know how to do mac and cheese. As well. Yeah, it's black-eyed.
Yeah, it's got like
salad.
Some cucumber in there, some really nice dressing.
And this bread, it's like a spice bread, what
yeah,
is
it? Yeah, it's honey rosemary.
Honey rosemary, it's delicious. And it came with some whipped butter. That's a receipt. But it looks a little bit like, it's not a receipt, sorry, it's a straw packet. But it looks a little bit like the whipped butter.
We've met Mickey, Goofy, and Daisy.
So we've still got to meet Minnie and.
Is Minnie here? We definitely have Donald.
Right, I'm gonna go and get some desserts though. So I'll leave Ella to eat her curry in peace and I'll go and get some desserts. I am back. There's a thing called an element. I am in it. We have all, they don't look necessarily normal person bite size, but they are definitely me size bite size. We have got a baby flamingo cake, a baby bee cake, a pineapple tart. I didn't get what this was actually. Maybe it's a tree of life. Marshmallow. We've got a Mexican layered cookie bar. We've got the trio brownie or something. A plant-based mousse, chocolate mousse tart. A double chocolate zebra cookie and a sugar cookie. That is every single one of the desserts that they serve here, minus the fruit salad. And now I'm gonna eat them. We can do a Frank's food review, but first, we've got our Mickey Mouse. Hi, Mickey. So for Frank's dessert review, what was I calling it, Ella, do you remember? I can't remember either, but we've advanced a little bit. I've got a tripod now, it's not Ella, so Ella's still eating her food there, but she's not even using her hands. I've got on a tripod setup. First we'll try the double chocolate zebra cookie. Who are we kidding? It's like your triple chocolate cookies, nice and chewy, very chocolatey, way more chocolatey than chocolate ice cream. Don't understand what chocolate ice cream is. It doesn't taste like chocolate. I'd rate that 7.5 out of 10. It's way better than your standard one, but not like exceptional. So a sugar cookie, American sugar cookie. Americans are known for these, you see them everywhere. Walmart, you can get boxes of them. Boxes and boxes, like 60 in a box. Give it a try. This one's got turquoise, purple, and lilac sprinkles on.
And that's for the 50th celebration.
Oh, it's for the 50th celebration. Let's give it a try. So it's like, imagine you've got a milk chocolate cookie without the milk chocolate. Just the biscuity base. But it's still soft, still good. The taste's pretty good. The sprinkles add a little bit of a crunch to it. But it seems to have some weird, like, chemically flavour. But a lot of the baked goods in America seem to have that. I don't know what it is. But it's still nice. I'd give it a five. Standard. So it's got a little
marshmallow.
Yeah, it's a marshmallow with a chimney. It's got a little tree of life on it as well. And a chocolate bottom. I don't know what it's called, I'll have to find out for you and come back to you on that, but let's try it. Give it a try. Mm. white chocolate disc, white and milk chocolate spiral straw stuck in the middle, dipped in chocolate and then dipped in biscuit crumb. Maybe it's supposed to be like a s'more.
Maybe.
It was nice. It was just marshmallow and chocolate, but marshmallow and chocolate go really well together. So I'm going to give that a... I'll give it a 7. It was good. It was nice. Let's try this plant-based chocolate mousse tart next. If I can... Ooh, that brownie is dense. And this chocolate tart is stuck to the plate. I got it. So this is it. It's got a solid chocolate base, chocolate mousse, and then maybe like a caramel.
What's that caramel?
It's a plant-based caramel sauce. Then a little orange florette of icing and a chocolate disc on there. I'll give that a try as well. Considering it's plant-based, I got chocolate all over my mouth. Considering it's plant-based, the plain chocolate on the bottom, which is standard, the mousse tastes very milky, like it's creamy. The caramel sauce must add to the sweetness to it. That's really good. I'd say that's like a... It's probably an 8. I'd choose that again. It's quite dense on the chocolate though. If you're not a chocolate fan, I'd probably give it a miss, but I like chocolate. Not much chocolate this holiday. Again, I'm going to save the rest. Some of these are slightly too big to do with down in one, so I'm going to give this layered cookie bar a go. It looks like
it's very pretty.
Yeah, it's got a little sunflower on it. It looks like it's maybe a cheesecake style base. Then it's in the middle bit. It looks like a white chocolate, maybe peanut butter in there. I'm going to give it a bite. I'll find out for you. Okay. It was like a cheesecake base. Then a doughy cookie dough. Donald's coming. A doughy cookie dough. And then just like a sugar icing sunflower with icing leaves. The icing makes it really sweet. I think it'd be fine with just the middle bit, to be honest. It could do without the cheesecake base and the cookie inside. But together, it's very sweet. Even for me, I've got a sweet tooth. That's very sweet. I'd say that's... I don't know, I'd say a 6 out of 10. It tastes a little bit nutty now, after the fact. I don't think there's any nuts in there though. Okay. I'm gonna try this pineapple tart to go. It's got a little edible leaf in there. Not sure what that is. It's chocolate. So it's like a tart look case. Pineapple custard or something inside. Is that a meringue? Oh, it's a small meringue. And then the chocolatey leaf. I'm gonna break that bit off so I don't choke on it. It's like blue glitter on my lips.
Blue glitter.
Yeah, I'm gonna do this down in one for those fans. All right. This is the opposite of a cookie bar. That could do with being more sweet. It's almost cheesecake-esque in the texture, maybe from the base and the pineapple custard. But it doesn't have it's got the flavour of pineapple, but not like the sour hit you get from pineapple, if that makes sense. It's almost like they've condensed the flavour, so it felt very flat. It was nice though. I'll give it You right there, Earl? What's wrong? Feeling full.
Yeah, it was like crunchy and sweet in my throat.
Crunchy and sweet. Was it one of my sprinkles?
It tasted like a sprinkle.
It might have been one of my sprinkles. I'm gonna rate that a 7. I'd say a 7. Next up, we'll give the baby flamingo cake. Look at that. It's a little flamingo on top. So the flamingo's icing, not chocolate. Now, the icing was the worst bit about the sunflower cookie bar. So I guess there's only one thing for it. Down in one. For being a pink flamingo, it tasted a lot of lemon. Surprise, like a lemon cake with the icing on top. Again, it was like a solid sugar flamingo. I could do without that. If it was just the icing like a pink cupcake, that'd be really good. Or if it had some white chocolate on there for the flamingo, that'd bring it up as well. I'd give it an 8. It was nice, it was good. An 8, like that. Oh, he's not generous.
That's very generous, I'd say.
Oh well. Happen now. Now this. I don't know what this bit is. Chocolate though. This one is a chocolate cake with the yellow icing. With a B on it. It was a baby bee cake. So I'm chewing and chewing and chewing. And I was expecting there to be a little bee on there, out of the hard icing. I didn't crunch a bee, so I don't know if that was meringue or something. It wasn't hard and crunchy. I'm not sure. The last one is this muffin. Not a muffin, a brownie. It's got a little white. Oh, look at that. So this is sort of the symbol of Tusker House. There you go. So you got Mickey, Minnie, Pluto, Goofy. And Donald. Give it a try, I think it's just white chocolate. It is. Just standard white chocolate. And the rest of the brownie has this purple flower and green grass.
That's cute.
This, I'm expecting big things. I'm expecting this to score highly. I'll be very disappointed if it doesn't. Let's see. Oh, oh my god. That is so fudgy. Like nothing else. Sticking my mouth together. Really chocolatey. That is a solid. If I'm rating just brownies, that's a 10 out of 10. If I'm rating all desserts ever, it's like a 9.5. That is a banging brownie, honestly. And that sort of concludes it. I don't think I'm going to be able to get any more down me. I'm going to finish what's on my little plate, which is only... it's only four halves. But I'm not... I don't think I'm going back for more. Maybe this one. It depends on how long Ella takes, but... she doesn't look too well at the moment. And that was my... I can't remember what I called it, like a dessert review? Yeah. Peace.
Is that Elf? Are you stretching? You enjoyed yourself, Elf? Thank you, Megan and Daniel, this was amazing.
Every time we make it in big bars and everything.
There's Mickey now.
Stuffed down. That was delicious. That brownie was the best brownie I've ever had. I hope I'm going to think about that now for the rest of my life. Ellie's just gone to the toilet. Then we're heading to Flight of Passage. So we've got a lightning lane that expires in 35 minutes. So we've got plenty of time to get there. We haven't had a picture with Donald yet, so we're going to see if we can track down Donald. And if we track down Donald, get a picture, then head over to Pandora.
I'm well aware that these are just people in suits. Like, the rational part of my brain knows that. But to me, I swear to God, I've just met Mickey Mouse. There is no purer joy than
then the joy of meeting the big man himself.
Just eagerly waiting for Donald to come back. We were the next table, we had to do a dance, and now they've disappeared. We've got a lighting limit that expires in 25 minutes. So our server's just gone to ask where they are, to find out what time they're coming back. And then we're heading off to Flight Passage and then home. We're hoping we get to see Donald there.
Another thing we will say is service here is brilliant, isn't it? So they've been really lovely, really friendly, and then we're waiting for Donald.
Yeah, so we came about 10 minutes ago now, and I said to the guy, we're just waiting for a picture of Donald, and he said, oh, we should get another drink or a cupcake or something.
There's Goofy.
There he is.
And he's like, don't worry, I'll stand here, I'll go find out where they are.
Look at that. It's our garden wall.
It is our garden wall. Goofy's coming in, so hopefully that means Donald's not too far behind. We got Donald Duck!
We got him. Oh, we've still got 20 minutes to get there.
Yeah, it's
well,
okay.
Well, just less, but we'll get there in time.
Yeah.
It was really, the server was really nice, our server. He took a picture for us, he was waiting, he was ready.
Yeah.
He was like, he's coming. So he knew we were waiting, but they all got it sorted. It's all sorted.
So we met all of the ones that we could meet. Yeah. Donald and Daisy and Mickey and Goofy.
Yeah.
In their safari outfits.
Oh, Ella loved it. That's why Ella chose Tusker, because they're the cutest outfits.
The cutest outfits.
You can get little toys where they're all wearing the outfits, which is quite cute, isn't it?
When we were kids, we used to have a really big Mickey Mouse that was in a safari outfit, and he was awesome and I loved him. So it's like, brings me back to my childhood.
And now you can get a box full of Christmas decorations where they're all wearing the safari outfits, which is pretty cool.
It was beautiful. I loved it. The food was also brilliant.
Yeah,
like, not
flawless, yeah. The that brownie. I'm gonna think about that for so long. So yeah,
delicious.
Just heading to Pandora now. That'll be the last bit. And then we are
going to Flight Passage.
We've changed up our plans, haven't we, actually? Instead of heading home after this, we're going to head to the outlets.
The Vineland outlets.
Because that's something we were going to do if we had time on a Friday. Because we're finishing early and we're already south, it makes sense to go to the outlets instead of back, before we head back.
Yeah, so they've got, it's got a lot of designer shops that
yeah.
We're not really that fussed about. There's a couple that you wanted to pop in, didn't you?
There's, yeah, I want to check Under Armour because someone's asked if I can get them a t-shirt that's only available in America. We don't know if we're going to have it, but we're going to have a look for them.
Have a look.
And then also, there's also a character.
Yeah, the Disney character warehouse, which is like a Disney outlet, so all merchandise that's like either defective or end of season or something like that.
And now that Ella's started pin trading, and we've got a lanyard that sells stuff. If there's any cheap pin badges going, we can pick up a few and then just trade them for the ones that we want.
Yeah, amazing.
So yeah, Flight of Passage will be next. We're scanned through now, so there's no more rush.
We're here.
We are here. Ella was just saying it's cool how to keep with the immersion.
The theming, yeah, of this area.
They don't have any big ride signs, so like the other ones you had, Kilimanjaro Safari.
There'd be like a big sign there. Instead, what they do is they've made it so it's as if the Na'vi have like made big sort of wicker.
Yeah, big wicker signs. So we took a picture before, we'll try and put them in if we can again. Testing our editing skills in the future without us even trying. But even look at the handrails, they've even got like ace right on them all and lamps.
Wow. I just find it insane.
So if you don't know how this is done, there's a big metal structure with girders along all those big vines. But it just brings up. It's incredible.
Like this.
So this is one of the wicker signs we were talking about. Instead of it saying Flight of the Banshee or whatever, it's just, it's so cool. And all of these things, we'll have to come back when it's night time or sometime, because they all glow like bioluminescent and glow in the dark and stuff. Which, it probably doesn't make sense saying that, but it looks so cool. They put so much effort into these things. I can't wait to try it. And there's like cave roaring and stuff. The Na'vi. All these cave paintings all along the theme. That's stunning.
Hello.
Thank you. And
this one.
We'll have to probably go through the normal queue at some point, because there is a huge one-to-one scale Na'vi in a tank.
Yeah, the avatar, like actual.
Yeah, the avatar that they have in the film in a tank, which is just...
We won't be able to film on this one.
No.
A weird ride system where you kind of like sit on a bike sort of.
Yeah, you sit on the banshee,
but
sitting like on a motorbike sort of style. But we'll give you a review after this morning. Just more of Pandora here. Right, Ella. What did we just do?
We just went on quite a passage and rode on a banshee.
So the whole story there is you go through one of the machines, the science machines, ACE, is it?
Yeah.
And they are linking you to an avatar that's already on the back of a banshee.
So you can do research, basically.
So you're doing research into the Akari. Which are the banshees.
Yeah, Ikran or something.
Ikran, yeah.
I can't quite remember.
And then you sit on one and you fly. And
you
really
feel
do.
It breathe.
Yeah, you're sitting over its back and you can feel it breathe. Every time it breathes, you feel pressure on your legs. And it was crazy.
I was literally speechless. I came up and I was just like, what?
Yeah, I said to Ella, there was a weird bit with where you go in like a cave. And I lost
the
3D immersion. But then when you started moving again, your eyes kicked back in and you were back in the 3D and it was just like you were flying. It was unreal.
So beautiful. It was just beautiful. That was where
it was, it's great. It's reignited a love for.
Yeah, you went
avatar.
Over like water and like you went in big waves. There was a big creature that jumped out the water.
Which I think are prominent in the way of water, the new one.
Yeah, I was thinking it was very much reminiscent of the teaser trailer that I saw.
Yeah, it's really cool, isn't it?
It was amazing. It was so good. I can't say anything else. It was amazing.
I'd definitely go on that again.
Well worth the lightning lane.
Yeah, so we're gonna head now to the exit. Well, if we can see any pictures on the way, we're going to get them, aren't we? And then head to the premium outlets.
Yeah, amazing.
So I'll catch you there. It's been a great day so far. Just, we don't want to be rushing it and pushing our legs too hard, but they're feeling all right at the moment, aren't they?
Yeah, they're okay.
So not too bad. So this is the tree. It's covered in animals. But to get the sheer scale of it, it's like one of those videos you watch where you just keep zooming out. Look at that. That's giant. We're probably 100 meters away from it. That's big. We're going to queue up and get a big professional photo, aren't we?
Yeah.
We've just done some pin trading.
Yeah, we have.
At the Discovery Trading Company, and then we're heading to the exit and heading for the rest of our day. Oh yeah, super easy.
You just go up and pick the one that you like from their board and give you one at the top.
Yeah. They might do a check to make sure it's an official Disney pin. But
I try
other than
and
that,
hand it to them
downside.
So it says on the back, you know, it says official Disney.
Yeah, but that is just stunning. And we're going to walk around that next time we're here.
Yes.
And see all the animals.